What's up? It's your girl Chatter Greatest, and welcome back to my YouTube channel, y'all. Today I am back again with another video for you guys. As you guys see by the title, your girl is going to be doing her vision board for you guys. I'm going to be creating my vision boards, breaking down what it is, how I did it, my goals, my dreams, aspiration, things like that. For those of you who do not know what a vision board is basically a board that you can look back at every day, every week, and mark it off, just basically like your goals before the year's out. As you guys know, we 3 months into 2021, so I don't know why I'm so late than it. I don't know why I'm so late doing this, but better late than never, right? Not too long ago, I printed out the pictures, things like that. I'm about to set up, go over with you guys what I think you should do to make your vision board, how to make your vision board, what kind of headspace you need to be in when making your vision board, and just basically like seeing yourself from like a greater eye, you know what I mean, and not really thinking small, you feel me, because no dream is you know, too out of this world to reach. Okay, you guys, so before I start, I want to break down to you guys, first things first, where to start at, what to do, what vibe you need to be on, what mood you need to be in. So let's do it. So I have my board. You can get one of these from a drugstore, Walmart, Office Depot is a good one. I got my glue sticks so I can stick these bad babies on there. My pictures printed out. How I printed my pictures out, you can print them out from like a Word document. You can download Word on your computer, or you can go to the library and ask them if you can print out in color. So what I did was I just like saw a whole bunch of pictures on Pinterest, on Instagram, like on Google that I wanted to use, and I just kind of like put them all in one Word document, printed them out on my printer in color, as you guys can see. And like I said, if you don't have a printer at home, you can go to the librarian and print this out, or ask, you know, a relative or somebody if you can come print it out in color. I feel like color is very important because it like give you that full effect, but like color make it pop, you know. When you make your vision board, you want to love your vision board, you know what I mean? You don't want to just be like, oh, I mean, my vision board cool. You want to love your vision board. You don't have to have this, but I'm a visual learner. I'm really technical. I try to be organized as much as I can. Like, I'm extra, y'all. Like, I'm that girl at school who binder match her pencil case. Like, I'm just that type of person. So what this here is, it's called a law of attraction planner. So I got this law of attraction planner about a year ago. You can get it off Amazon for like $30, or just go on Google, put shopping, just type in law of attraction planner. But I got mine off Amazon. It came in about 2 days. And yeah, so I'm gonna open it up for you guys. It has many different like slots, things that you can write in it. That's what I've been working on, things like that. So it say like goal setting, set 50 goals in all areas of your life. Create harmony on all levels, mission and vision statements, awareness and self-discovery, things like that, that you can like really write down, and they give you like many tasks you can do. So about a year ago, I had started writing in my law of attraction planner. You're really supposed to write in it every day, but I always forget to, or I always just end up doing something. The reason why I recommend this law of attraction planner is because I feel like a vision board is pretty much a law of attraction planner, except it's pictures. You're not writing it down. You can, but it's just a little different. Literally, a lot of goals that I had set for last year, before 2021 even came about, I had already got through it, or I had already done it without even putting it on the board. Like, I just wrote it down and I just thought of it. I saw myself there and I made it happen. So I would section it: free time and family, health, financial, career / business, relationship, personal development, and spiritual. So what I did was just basically like write hella goals. So spiritual, pray more, start going to church, protect my energy, faith without work is dead, like things like that. I'll just like jot down what I'm feeling or what I'm thinking. Create harmony on all levels. This is actually my outline for my vision board, for me to even like have so many ideas in my mind, because literally, y'all, like when y'all start making y'all vision board, y'all sit there and be like, damn, like, all right, let me see what I'm gonna put on here. But with this you know, law of attraction planner, or like I said, you can write this down at home on a piece of paper and just section it yourselves. The only difference is they got it on there for you and you just write under it. But don't be lazy, girl. Just get a piece of paper, pencil, markers, and do your thing. You don't have to spend $35 on a book, on a planner. So enough about the law and attraction planner. I would totally like put the link in the description down below so you guys can check it out and buy one if you want. But I don't recommend it because it's not needed. But if you a girly girl like me and you just that extra girl in class who pencils gotta match your book bag and your binder, then go up right ahead. You feel me? But yeah, so I use my law and attraction planner. That's how I outline what I wanted my goals to be, what I was looking for, how I wanted to conquer my goals, what I was going to do to work towards them more. And I use this book. After I saw hella stuff that is pictures and stuff that inspired me and relates to what I jotted down. Like I said, and you print it out in color like here. The first thing you want to do is put on something comfortable. As you guys see, I got on shorts, a little baggy shirt, so I can just be comfortable and in a good headspace and free feeling. Put on something comfortable because it is time consuming. I'm gonna tell you that right now. Like, this ain't no just little take a couple minutes like now. Like, you literally gotta sit down, figure out what you want your life to be like, how you see yourself a year from now, 6 months from now, 3 months from now, where you want to be at by that time. And if you do not be there by that time, what are you going to do to, you know what I'm saying, replace it with something better? Number two, you want to put on, like, maybe light a candle or something. So I have a candle here, but I want to use this candle because, yeah. So you want to light a candle to, like, really set the mood, you know what I mean? Like, good vibes, good energy, good scent. Next thing you want to do, write down like what you want your goals to be, like just section it out. Like I said, I section mine in four. You don't have to do what I do. Do what you feel, or do what you feel you need to work on before the year's out. So like I said, my whole thing was my health, business, my recreation, like my creative juices, things like that. Before you start posting stuff on your vision board, you want to figure out like a room in your home that you want to kind of like vibe in and be comfortable in. So as you guys can see, I picked my bedroom. Y'all know I never do videos on my bedroom, but I feel like my bedroom, first of all, my bedroom is really cozy. Like, this is like my safe haven. This is where I sleep. This is where the magic happens. I just want to chill out. This is where I sleep. This is where I pray. This is where I relax at. This is where I think things through, or, you know, just really vibing. So I picked my room because my kitchen got too much stuff going on in there. It got food in there. It got my dogs in there. Like, it's just it just gets me distracted easily in my... Then my YouTube room, like my business room, is so cluttered. So I didn't want to do in there. And you've got the living room. But like I said, my dogs be playing in the living room a lot. So they have toys all around, things like that. And another thing you want to do, you want to straighten up your area that you're going to do your vision board in. So you can just have a clear mind, a clear headspace. So you can just like dive right in without moving things around, moving stuff off your bed. I'm not necessarily say clean up, but just straighten up, like be more organized. Before you start, you want to pick like a really good playlist that'll get your creative juices going, that'll really make you feel inspired, that'll really make you feel good, make you feel happy. I'm actually going to play some gospel because gospel like really just had me thinking like long-term goals, like really put me in my feelings to like have a positive mindset going. So yeah, y'all, now I'm about to paste my stuff on my vision board and I'm gonna let y'all know how it go. All right, y'all, so like 45 minutes later, your girl is finally done cutting out all of her pictures that she want on her vision board. I actually did not paste them yet, like I didn't glue them yet, because I wanted to like figure out how I was gonna fit all of the goals on one board. And it worked out great. So I'm about to do that. And I'm gonna talk to y'all in a minute. Okay, guys. So your girl is finally done with her vision board. Looking at this board is like really making me inspired. Like really kind of teary-eyed on the low, because it's like I have all of these big goals, and it's like I feel like as soon as I wake up, I need to, you know what I'm saying, get on it. You know what I mean? It just really made me inspired, and like the fact that I can like see this in my future, or the fact that I can see this, see myself at this point, is powerful in itself, because if you can see it, you can believe it. You wouldn't even be thinking if you couldn't see yourself at that point in life, I don't even think I would have jotted it down. You know what I'm saying? And it's kind of like my goals are very simple, very, not gonna say simple, but my goals for 2021 is very like reachable. And I kind of like then think outside the box. You know, when you do these, you know, year by year vision boards, you don't necessarily want to like say, oh yeah, I'm gonna make $1 million tomorrow. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's possible, you know what I mean, but not really. So, you know, I tried to be very like reasonable with my goals. I was in a really good headspace. It's very neat. Like, I really feel like I can see myself at this point. I'm not necessarily going to elaborate on what I got on my board. I just wanted you guys to kind of check it out. Simply because, you know, when you're doing these vision board, guys, you don't necessarily want to share your goals with everybody and their mama, because it's kind of like that's something that you need to get, you know what I mean? And you don't want to say something and don't happen. Then it's like, well, no, you don't want to mess something up. And also too, like, people, everybody don't like got your best interest at heart. So, you know, you can have a goal about something and they'll see it and they'll be like, you know, kind of like wish negativity on you. And that's really, it's possible, you feel me? So you never want somebody who don't, you know what I'm saying, your work ethic, or who don't believe in you, to be like, oh, why you got that on your board? Like, you think you can do that? You know what I'm saying? Because things like that can get discouraging to us humans, because we are very emotional beings at times. So just know, like, everything on my board, it's like I'm looking at it and it's like I cannot stop smiling. Like, I just feel so happy and inspired. Another thing I did was like cut my phone off and kind of just isolated myself from the world, because I kind of just wanted to focus and really see myself and figure out how I'm going to conquer this and things like that, because that's important. So tomorrow I'm going to Office Depot. I'm going to get, like, you know, the little clear thing that you can get over it to get it like molded in, so it won't come off or rip or anything. So as soon as Office Depot open tomorrow, I'm going to go do that. I also too, each one that I reach, each goal I reach, I'm going to like thumbtack it with like red thumbtacks or clear thumbtacks, things like that. So hey y'all, as you guys can see, y'all hear my gospel playing in the background. I hope YouTube don't demonetize me. But yeah, you guys, that really completes this vision board. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. I really hope I inspired some of you guys to make your vision board and things like that. I love y'all so much. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. Peace and bless.